Hello guys, Apple Times here, welcome to a new video, and today we have the unboxing of a very exciting product, arguably the most exciting product launched by Apple in 2023, and that is of course the Lightning to USB-C adapter. Okay, so of course, as you probably know by now, the European Union forced Apple to adopt USB-C in the iPhones, which was actually the only Apple product that didn't have USB-C yet. And as part of that move, Apple released this. This is an adapter to use your existing Lightning cables or accessories with your new iPhone for USB-C. So I'm assuming this works with headphones, chargers and everything. But I actually want to give this video a twist. I don't want to make it just an unboxing. Of course, I'll do an unboxing. I'll tell you the features. I'll give you my opinion and everything. But I want to try this with other stuff. Like, I don't know, charging the Mac with a Lightning port via the adapter, charging a Nintendo Switch, charging the camera that I'm recording with right now. All of that, we'll test this out and just have a bit of fun. So yeah, first of all, let's unbox it. As usual, they have the pull tab, which is now actually made of paper instead of plastic in Apple's move to transition away from plastic in the packaging by the end of next year, as they said in the keynote. But yeah, very familiar experience. We just unbox it and here it is. Oh, actually, I expected it to come this way, but it comes this way. Anyway, ooh, it's fancy because I hadn't realized, but it's actually a braided cable. So this tiny piece of cable is braided, which is nice. Then, yeah, that's it. We just have the adapter. That's literally it. There's nothing else to it. But yeah, it's kind of fun. I could compare it with other adapters. Actually, you know, let's do that. Okay, so I'm back and I brought with me some of the adapters I have. I have the two SD card adapters, the one for USB-C and the one for Lightning. But I have them in the camera bag, so not gonna find them. But yeah. So these are the three we have. Of course, the shape at the bottom is very different on each of those, but the cable part is what I'm interested in. Some are lighter, some are thinner. Actually, the USB-C to USB-A adapter is the thinnest. And this one is, I would say, on the thick end. No, actually, it's on the thin end. And yeah, it's the shortest of the bunch. And yeah, just, I guess. Yeah, but it's the only one that's braided. And that's a nice touch, actually. Now this, I didn't mention it, but this is 35 euro? Did I pay 35 euro for this? Anyway, yeah, this is not cheap. Is it actually 35 euro? Wow. Yeah, this is 35 euro. For 35 euro, you can get an AirTag or you can get this. Your iPhone 15 will of course come with a USB-C cable included. If not, you can get some pretty cheap ones in IKEA and everything. And then Apple has, of course, the super expensive ones that have USB-C speeds and, USB 3 speeds and even Thunderbolt 4. So yeah, you could use those as well. But now, since I spent all this money on that, we will try it. Now, I cannot try it with the iPhone 15, of course, because it hasn't been released yet. So that's something I cannot do. But let's have some fun and try it with some stuff. So first of all, we will try it with the Mac. Okay, so the moment of truth. Now, all of these tests that I'm gonna do is with the 90 watt USB-C adapter by Apple. So yeah, we'll see if this works. This is actually the one that came with the Mac, so you should be able to charge it. And it is charging. Okay, I didn't really expect this. But it is charging. Okay, so I guess now I can use a Lightning cable to charge my Mac. That's good. Okay, good. Next up, we'll use a Nintendo Switch. Okay, so next up, we have the Nintendo Switch. This is the OLED version. This is my girlfriend's actually, so yeah, I just stole it from her for this video. But yeah, we'll try to charge it. And it charges. Okay, so this is actually gonna prove more useful than anything else. This is actually good, because like if you have a lot of Lightning cables lying around, which you probably have at this point, for the easy price of 35 euro, which is probably like $30, I think it's $29 actually what it's sold for, you can use this to charge a lot of stuff. So this is pretty cool. So you could actually, still take, so if you have an older iPhone and you have, say, an iPad mini or any iPad for that matter, and you're going on a trip, you can actually only take a lightning cable and then take this, and you can charge everything with this adapter. Even, yeah, if you take your Switch, if you take your Mac, that's actually a good one. That's a very nice, interesting find. And okay, so this is actually power delivery. It only charges with power delivery stuff. The power bricks by Apple are power delivery, which is very nice. And now we will try with a camera. Okay, so this beast right here is the Nikon Z8 or Nikon Z8, whatever you pronounce it. And it also charges via power delivery, via USB-C. Everything now charges via USB-C, even the iPhone. Nah, man, that's crazy. Okay, so we'll try to plug it in. And we should see the light here. Usually it takes a while. Yeah, here it is. It's charging as well. Wow, that's nice, actually. I can't believe I'm actually using the lightning cables for stuff now. No, but yeah, as I said, like, it works on everything. Like, for the sake of it, let's try it on the DJI mic, which is actually what I'm recording this video with, on the case. And it's charging as well. Wow, yeah, so this is good, because this, I don't know exactly how the power delivery standard works, but if it needs the actual connector or something to transmit it, and the cable, both the lightning and the adapter do transmit it, so that's good, because you can charge absolutely everything with this adapter. That's crazy. But yeah, having done all these tests, do I recommend it? Actually, yeah, I do recommend it. Now, it's expensive, but I think it's actually helpful if you're gonna travel a lot, even at home. Like, now if you're gonna buy the iPhone 15, you'll probably have a bunch of lightning cables lying around that you don't know what to do with them. If you have all that money to spare, you can buy one for each of them. But if you only buy one, you can repurpose one of those cables. I think it's great. It's a very good idea by Apple to release this. And yeah, this is great. This is very, I'm actually surprised. I didn't think it would work. Especially with the Mac. With this, for some reason, even though they're not Apple products, I thought, yeah, maybe they work, because they don't need as much power or anything. But the Mac works, so that's impressive. Not gonna lie. But yeah, this is everything I wanted to show you today. If you have any questions about this adapter, please let me know down below in the comments and I will do my best to answer, as usual. And yeah, this tiny little boy actually surprised me. I'm happy with it. But yeah, if you liked the video, you can please thumbs up. And if you like Apple in general and you want to see more content like this or Apple-rated content of any kind, you should consider subscribing, because that's exactly what I post. But yeah, thank you very much for watching, and see you in the next one.